Hey, what's going on? I'm Dave from Tech and Droid, and welcome to the full feature focus video on EUI 5.9.26s for the LeEco Le2. So as soon as you unlock the phone, the very first thing you will notice is the presence of an app drawer. So now you can choose between either to have an app drawer or to have all apps on the home screen just as usual. And now moving on to the themes application, when you apply certain themes, specifically themes with 5.9.23s mentioned in the description, the theme is applied to both dialer and the messaging application as well. And now you can also download various fonts from the store, but for both full-fledged themes and online fonts to work, you need to set the region as mainland China in settings. The look and feel of certain inbuilt apps like gallery, browser and calendar has also changed a little bit. And in phone manager, just like in 23s beta, we have an app accelerator option and a permission manager option built in. Now moving on to the stability and performance of the ROM. The ROM is almost bugless and perfect once you tweak in a couple of things. So the first thing is, in location settings, you need to disable Tencent location settings for the GPS to work properly. Once you disable it, GPS will work without any issues. And the next thing is Vivo LTE. Though Vivo LTE works fine in this ROM, but from time to time, especially after a reboot or so, Vivo LTE disappears. But you can bring Vivo LTE back online by just turning on and off the airplane mode. And the last thing is with quick charging. While the phone charges just as fast as any other EUI ROM from 0 to 90%, once the phone reaches 90%, the charging speed decreases drastically. As I know that it's absolutely normal for the last 10% to charge slowly. The thing is, it's even slower than other EUI ROMs like 19S or 20S. I personally think that LeEco has intentionally slowed down the charging speed to prevent the device from overheating. Though this is not an issue, I just wanted to point it out. Now moving on to the performance, this ROM just flies. The ROM is snappy and UI elements like transition effects and animations are smooth and on point, even smoother than they were in other UI ROMs. The ROM also comes with the latest Android security update, which is the main security patch, which makes this the only UI ROM with the latest Android security patch. Now in terms of battery backup, this ROM has one of the best battery life, almost on par with small EUI by RL. So overall, barring the slightly unstable Vivo LTE, this ROM is a complete package. I personally like this ROM a lot. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. If you like this video, you know what to do. Go down and hit the like button. And for more videos, hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon right next to that subscribe button so that you get notified as soon as I upload a new video. And I will see you guys later. See ya.